everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have a highly requested video. I mentioned it in my What's in My Backpack video back in like September when I first started school. And I talked about doing a studying video, tips and tricks on note taking and studying. So I'm finally getting around to doing that because it is exam time for me. It's the beginning of December. So I have exams for 2 weeks and then I have a month off school. So I'm so excited to just get these exams over with. Like this week I'm studying and then my exams start next week. So I've already done a lot of my preparation and I just want to show you guys some of my tips and tricks. I have it all like planned out here on my iPad. I wanted to first talk about how I organize my notes. So I usually have a folder for each class, and I like to kind of like match either the color of the textbook or the color of my notebook if I do have a notebook for that class. So I like things to kind of color coordinate as best as they can, but you know, sometimes that doesn't work out. And inside I just have my printed notes. This will work best for somebody in university. I feel like high school is better to have binders, but in university a lot of your notes are like given to you from the professor, so you kind of just print them off, and like there's different methods that you can do with that, but I find that I don't have too much paper, so a folder will work fine. And then for some classes I do have a notebook. I have like bigger notebooks too, but this one is just small because I knew I wouldn't be writing too much for that class, but again, I just needed a notebook. I have my planner, which I'm going to talk about, which is really important. And then my pencil case. So I'm going to go through all of these. So first, when it comes to note taking, I think you need to do what works for you. Yes, I can tell you some of my tips and tricks, but I can't tell you what will work best for you and how you will learn the material best. For me, it really depends on the subject. Some classes and how it's taught to you. Some classes they give you a PowerPoint, some classes it's just like straight note taking that you have to do on your own. Sometimes they'll give you like Word documents, or sometimes it's just a lot of like reading from the textbook and making your own notes on your own. So I think you need to take how that course is taught and also how you learn best and then figure out a method that works best for you. So for example, psychology, that's my elective. They give me PowerPoints. My professor posts them online, but they're just like basic PowerPoints, so you have to like add in while she's talking. So for that specific class, I bring my laptop and I'll take the PowerPoint presentation. I will put it into outline format. I'll copy and paste it to a Word document. Then I have everything that she has given me in black font, and then in blue font I will add in my own notes. Then, so those are the notes that I'm taking while she's speaking. So it's things that she's mentioning. If she repeats it more than once, I'll like put a star next to it. You know, I'll like format it with different bullets. And then when I print it, everything in black is what she gives me. And then everything in blue, I know that is what she said and I add it in on my own. Then when I'm studying, I'll print it off and then like highlight and then write more in pen. And just like go crazy with highlighting. I like to make a lot of like acronyms on my page just so that I can remember it. And a big tip for when you print your notes, print them back and front. I have some diagrams. I like to print in color just because I like to see the two different colors. The black font is what she gives me, and then the blue font is what I wrote on my own. Just so that I know, but if you want to print in black and white, that's perfectly fine too. Because then you can just go in and add color with your highlighters. I find that color makes such a difference. It really like directs my eye to different areas on the page. So I know if something's underlined, it's more important, or if like it's underlined in red, it's usually a title. Like I just organize my notes like crazy, super organized. So that's what works best for psychology. Then for accounting, which I have in blue. And I'm taking accounting because I am going to school for business. So psychology is just my elective. It's just, I had like a list of a couple electives that I had to choose from. So I picked psychology for that, but the rest of my courses are all business related. So for accounting, they give me a PowerPoint and I'll print 6 slides to a page in black and white. Again, double-sided. before the class, the day before the class, they'll post the PowerPoint, I'll print it off, and then bring it with me to class. And then I'll highlight and like write other notes, and then we'll do like examples and stuff so I have like room to like write down. So I have each chapter stapled together, and then I just have them all in my folder, and that's how I organize them. That's like what I find works best for me, and that's how I stay really organized, just because we do one chapter a week. University is a little bit different, or even like your university or college might be different from mine, so this is just what works best for me. Alright, so in my next class, this one is actually economics. I find that it works best for me just to write everything down in a notebook, because my professor doesn't post anything online. He does everything just like he projects it up onto the screen, and it's you just copy down what he posts and what he is talking about. And then you've got to pick and choose what to write. You're not going to write every single thing that he like shows you. You've got to like summarize while you're making your notes. But economics is a lot of like diagrams and stuff, so I just find that I'm able to just write it out like with a pencil and paper, you know, old fashioned, and then I can color coordinate and highlight and just make it all pretty, and I find that's the way that I learned best. And there's not too much note taking that we do in that class. Like, it is the whole class that we're taking notes, but I mean like they're not extensive notes where I'm writing like 20 pages each day. So that's why I find like writing out with a pencil and paper works best for me. Sometimes if your class, like in psychology, for me it's easier to type it because it's just like all words. But here there's a lot of diagrams, so I just find that I am better off just writing and drawing. And it's a lot of like solving problems, like so there's math involved, so it's just easier to just write it out, and I don't know, that's what my notes look like. Then finally, the last way to take notes that I actually use is in my textbook. So this is my psychology textbook. I have a sticky note to separate our different tests. So we had two tests. It was like half of the chapters. So I separated this stuff until the next chapter is all going to be on my test number one. So here I'll go through my textbook, and because I like own these books, I can write in them and like highlight if I really want to. So you can see I highlighted and I wrote on a sticky note. These are the full adhesive post-it notes, so it doesn't really hang off the page. It has a full adhesive back to stick on. So I'll just highlight important things. Here I highlighted all important names in orange, like just important sentences will be in yellow. Again, there's more important names. This is so that I can look back in my textbook and be like, okay, orange. Okay, I need to know Edward, yeah, and James, yep. or like Sigmund Freud, you know, like you can look back, see the name and be like, okay, so what did he do? That's what I find works best for psychology, and then I'll just like write out definitions like in my own words. I do this along with my other notes that I showed you before, how I print off the PowerPoint, added in different colors and whatever. So this is just like when I go through the textbook, because I do reference the textbook, and I just highlight it and make it look pretty. And when you're highlighting things, make sure not to highlight like the entire page. Read it over and then go back and highlight what you think was important in that paragraph or in that section, because you could like be like, oh yes, this is important and this and this, and the next thing you know, your whole page is highlighted. That's not good. You wanna, I think it was, is it like less than 2% of your page should be highlighted or something like that? I learned that somewhere. I don't even know. Maybe it was 20, no, 20% is too much. I think it was 10 or 2% of your page should be highlighted if you're gonna highlight. That's probably a little bit more than 2%, but you know, I highlighted the important things there. And then the final method of note-taking that I've heard of is voice recording. You can do this from your laptop, from your iPhone, any kind of smartphone, I guess, would have a voice recording option. And this would be recording like lectures in university, and then being able to play it back. I actually saw someone, because I commute to school, so I saw another student on the train listening to a lecture that she had recorded, so I don't know if she actually recorded it or if she, like, a friend sent it to her or something, but she was listening to the lecture and then, like, retyping her notes, so obviously that worked for her, but I've never personally tried it. If you have, let me know in a comment below and let me know how that works for you. So now that I covered all the things on note-taking, now I'm moving on to actually studying. So these are the notes that you make during class, during your semester. Then when it comes time for a test, I think you need at least a week to fully prepare yourself for a test. And this would be like a bigger test, like a midterm or like a final exam, you know. But in high school, sometimes like small quizzes, you don't need a week to prepare if you've been keeping up all semester. So the first thing that I have to say is review, because that's the only way you're going to know your material. And I think you need to review less often, like throughout the beginning of the week, but then when it gets closer to the date of your test, like 3 days before, you should be doing like long review sessions, at least over an hour. This is just so that the material is like fresh in your mind and always being activated. And then it really depends on the subject that you're doing, because if it's something like math, then you need to actually be doing problems. But if it's something like psychology, where you're learning different theories and definitions and stuff like that, then that you can just be like reviewing your notes kind of thing. Another good way to learn a lot of terms and definitions, something that I found helpful for my IT class, is making flashcards. So this was for Unit 1. There was like so many definitions, but it was a multiple choice midterm with only definitions. So I found that flashcards worked really well for me. There was a lot of definitions and it was really time consuming to make the flashcards. So if you don't have the time, skip the step. But I like making flashcards because, like I said, I commute to school. So this is something I can do while I'm just sitting there on the train, you know. It's a 40-minute train ride, so I'm just like flipping through. Again, I highlight and like coordinate colors. Sometimes I'll put like more than one term on the card. I've seen people put the definition on one side of the card and the term on the like back or the front, whatever. I like to have it all on one side just so that I can see it and then flip through. I don't know. This is just what works for me and I'm just sharing that with you guys. Another thing that I wanted to mention is that the type of environment that you study in should be matching the same environment that you're going to be taking the test in. So this is something I learned in psychology. So if you're going to take the test in a really quiet room, I suggest studying in a really quiet room. So this would mean not studying with music on. Personally, music is not something I can study with because I get really distracted. I don't know how some people do it. Like, my brother will have like blasting music while he's studying and I don't quite understand that, but if that's something that works for you, don't change it just because I said so. But it is like something that I learned in psychology, that you should match the environment of which you study to which you take the test in. And then that also goes with state of mind. And then the final and best study tip that I have for you is sleep. Yes, sometimes sleep can be sacrificed if you need extra time to review, but I think you should plan ahead so you're not cramming the night before, which is something I need to take. I need to take my own advice on that one, but sleep is really important the night before a big test, and also breakfast the next morning. So eat properly and sleep properly will help your mind be prepared to write a test. So those are the note-taking and studying tips I have for you. I just wanted to show you my pencil case to show you all the crazy highlighters I have. I like to have... Okay, let's look at all the colors I have. Then I also have different color pens just because I like to make different colored notes. Oh, just dropped a highlighter. Different colored notes, but then I just write in basic blue pen. My favorite pen, if you are wondering, is a Paper Mate Comfort Mate Ultra 0.8 fine tip. I also have a Sharpie in here for writing my flashcards. And then I have two pencils just because, like, when taking tests, you often have to use Scantron. You need a good eraser if you're doing Scantron because you gotta erase if you make a mistake. And I also have whiteout in here somewhere. So I think you need at least two pens. Oh, I also have a black pen because I like to write and black pen or blue pen for different things. I don't know. It all makes sense in my head, but sometimes I'm like a little bit crazy with my note taking. And then finally, I wanted to just show you briefly my agenda. I like to plan out, this was September, so a really long time ago, but I like to plan out in different colors what is happening on that day. So I'll make like a little legend. So I have yellow for tests, orange for assignments, purple for midterms, pink for exams, blue for school events that I'm attending, and then green for life events. So life events, I have like my work schedule, and then I have in blue, I have the first day of school, then I have like all my tests, assignments, and I'll write like the course code, I guess, and then like what it is, like a little brief description. And then same with the assignment, the course code, and then brief description. And then this just keeps me organized, because I have a whole month view. And I'll do this like the first week of school so that I can plan out my whole semester. And then I can flip through and just see like, okay, this week I have two tests and one assignment due, so I need to plan my time accordingly. And it's just all about time management. Studying is all about time management because you have to allow the time to study to do a good job doing it. So I really hope this video wasn't too long, and I hope you guys found it helpful. These are just some studying tips and note-taking tips that I use personally. You guys might study way different than me, but this is just what I do. I hope you guys all enjoyed. Let me know if you find this useful, and if you guys have any study tips, share them with me and the other people in the comments below. I think it'll be really useful to read. So I hope you guys all enjoyed, and I'll talk to you later. Bye! Also, don't forget to take study breaks. Frequently, but not too long. Study breaks including making videos like I am right now.